These are the craziest iPhone accessories I've ever seen. And they just keep getting weirder. For this video, I dove deep into some of the strangest parts of the internet to find some of the most bizarre, dangerous, and some of the most expensive iPhone accessories I have ever seen. But don't worry, I've also got some normal accessories that are a great pair for the iPhone that you've got and that are actually well worth your money. So let's take a look at some of the coolest accessories you can pick up for your iPhone 12 or earlier, and some really crazy accessories that you should definitely not waste your money on. And a big thanks to Awesun for sponsoring this video. So I don't even know where to begin in this video, but I think it's only fair that we start with the most infamous product on this list, something that has garnered the most attention over the years, and something you've probably seen in one way or another over the last 10 years, and that is this, which is the iPhone umbilical cord charging thing. I don't even know what you call this thing. It first emerged on YouTube back in 2010, and since then has garnered millions and millions of views, and has definitely spread like wildfire over the internet because it's really strange, really odd, and just plain weird. It's called the Grow Cable, and it moves and vibrates while it charges your phone in the pouch sleeve. I don't even know what you would call this thing. I guess to kind of simulate an umbilical cord. There were rumors that this was more of an art piece, kind of an installation to showcase kind of a human's dependency on their phone. But really, it just is this really crazy, weird iPhone accessory that you just can't stop looking at. And it has a very unique movements and vibrations and is just a crazy iPhone charger. It works with a standard Apple wall plug on one end, and I'm gonna assume some kind of 30-pin dock on the other end inside, because that looks to me like either a 3GS, an iPhone 3G, it's an older iPhone for sure, but it works, and it's actually charging that iPhone. Now, what's weird about this story is that it recently took a very odd twist. So this Grow Cable kind of emerged, it kind of went around social media and the internet, and then we didn't really hear anything for a number of years. But then, just a couple of years ago, the Grow Cable has emerged, and you can now actually buy it. You can get it shipped to your door in 6 to 8 weeks for the low, low price of just a little over $6,000. So you've now got a choice between a new Mac Pro or this creepy iPhone umbilical cord charger. Should not be a hard choice. So this next one is definitely not as creepy as the iPhone umbilical charging cable, but this one is just as weird nonetheless. It is a levitating wireless charger for your iPhone. It's called the Overcharge and will charge your iPhone wirelessly, but also suspend it in thin air and make it move in a circular motion and kind of levitate as it wirelessly charges. It looks kind of like a party trick. It looks kind of cool, I guess, but your iPhone is just going to spin and spin and spin while it wirelessly charges. According to the Kickstarter campaign for this thing, which you'll notice is kind of a common theme for a lot of accessories in this video, the Overcharge uses a combination of magnets and induction charging to wirelessly charge your phone and also make it float in thin air at the same time. Of course, this is long before MagSafe on the iPhone or any kind of Qi wireless charging, so this used a special case with some special components inside to make all of this magic happen, quite literally. I'm not really sure if this thing ever made it to market, though it did raise $60,000 of funding on Kickstarter. Though the last update for this campaign was back in 2017, so I'm gonna guess things are not looking too good for Overcharge these days. So let's move on from a magical wireless charger that you really should not buy and waste any money on to one that you actually can buy and is actually very much well worth your money. This is the Nomad Base Station Pro, and it essentially delivers on kind of the promise and magic of AirPower in a tangible wireless charger that you can actually buy today. It allows you to charge three devices simultaneously and it'll work with any Qi-enabled device. So iPhones, AirPods, AirPods Pro, any kind of Android device. If it charges with a regular kind of Qi standard, it's going to work perfectly on the Nomad Base Station Pro. It's packed with 18 coils inside and really kind of delivers on kind of that AirPower promise. You can pretty much drop your device anywhere on this mat and it's going to charge wirelessly at 7.5 watts. Unfortunately, there is no MagSafe fast charging here, so it's all limited just to 7.5 watts. And also there's no proprietary magnet solution for the Apple Watch, so the Apple Watch really doesn't charge on here. But besides that, any kind of Qi-enabled phone, wireless earbuds like the AirPods Pro, those are all going to work very nicely on here. And if you're looking looking for a little wireless charging magic, check out the Base Station Pro from Nomad. Another really cool iPhone accessory that the team here really likes is this Backbone gaming controller. It's a physical gaming controller for your iPhone that gives you kind of all the tactile button goodness, the nice joysticks, a D-pad, to let you really have physical controls to play the games you want to play on your mobile device. This is perfect for the new iPhone 12 or even one of the earlier iPhones. And if you're super into Apple Arcade or you're kind of preparing for the launch of xCloud or Stadia when they someday make their way to the iPhone and you really want physical controls, this is going to be one of your best bets. The Backbone is just built really well. It's comfortable. The buttons are nice and tactile, really responsive. Well, this is definitely one of our favorite iPhone accessories and definitely one of the best controllers we've seen for the iPhone. So if you want to play some games and have that kind of console tactile button experience, check out the Backbone controller. All right, that was a nice break, but let's go back to this dystopian reality and look at some more weird iPhone accessories. And I can't tell if this DeLorean case is the coolest iPhone case that I have ever seen, or if it is the most bulky, most impractical nightmare of a case that anyone could ever attempt to strap onto their iPhone. This DeLorean case does give you full access to your iPhone, but when you're not using your phone, you can kind of set it down on a table or a flat surface kind of face first, and then have a display of a light up DeLorean, which does look kind of cool, though this thing is just super impractical. I will say that it's really cool to see some of the parts of this case actually like retract to reveal the camera, and then the way this thing kind of pops and disassembles to get your phone out is super cool, but this thing is just, it's so big, it's so bulky, you cannot fit this thing in a pocket. So as cool as it looks, this has gotta be the most impractical iPhone case I've ever seen. Though it does look very, very cool, and yes, you can actually buy this thing on Amazon. Chances are, if you're like me, there's been more times than I'd like to admit that I've needed to get into my computer to grab a file, to upload something to the web, or to like check on a video export, only to realize that I had no way to remote into my computer and make any of that happen. Let's fix that right now. Your future self will thank you. Let's set up some remote access to your Mac and PC by using Awesome to give you full control of your computer no matter where you are. And now you have access to your computer from pretty much anywhere. You can download the Awesome app on iOS or Android. You could also do it as well on Mac or PC, and then you can remote in your computer and be able to operate it like you're sitting in front of it. One of my favorite features is the ability to super easily mirror your mobile phone to the Awesome program on your computer. This is great if you wanna just get a larger view of what you're looking at on your phone, you wanna do some application testing, or best yet, if you're doing a lot of tech support with friends and family members and they have an issue on their phone, instead of having them try to describe what they see, they could just mirror their phone display onto the computer screen, and then you have a total view to be able to see exactly what's going on, exactly what the problem is. It is way easier and has personally saved me so much time. Even better, if they're using an Android device, Awesome has the ability to allow you to have full control over that remote device. So if you wanna get even more technical in here, dive deeper and fix the problem for that person yourself, you have that ability with Awesome to do just that. And if you want even more features, you can get a pro account through Awesome that's gonna unlock things like remote command, and on Android, a game mode that'll let you stream the PC games you have on your PC to your Android device in excellent quality, and also has a custom keyboard you can use as well to play those games. So whether you wanna play your PC games remotely, you wanna do some tech support for your friends or family members, or if you just wanna have total control of your computer from anywhere in the world, you gotta get Awesome today and get started. We're gonna leave a link to it down below. Get it downloaded, get it set up. Again, your future self is definitely going to thank you. Let me introduce you to the Kissinger, or the Kiss Messenger. This is an iPhone accessory that you slot your iPhone into, and then with a combination of pressure-sensitive sensors and different motors, you can send a kiss from your mouth onto this accessory to someone else anywhere in the world who also has a Kissinger with their iPhone as well. I mean, the video basically speaks for itself, but you put the iPhone in there, you can have a video conversation, and then if you wanna kiss, you can put your lips on this thing and the motion will be captured and then sent over to the other Kissinger device. And the rest just kinda speaks for itself. I couldn't find any pricing information or availability information on this thing, but maybe that's for the best. But it was in development just a few years ago, and maybe this could be like the growth cable and it suddenly reemerges for a very crazy, ludicrous price. Now, a lot of the accessories I found while searching the web for this video were just kind of ridiculous, and some of them were expensive, and not a lot of them, or even any of them, were quite frankly very much worth your money. But one that I kept seeing over and over again was this ear-shaped iPhone case, which, haha, it's kind of funny. You hold it up to your ear when you're on a phone call, it looks like you have a big ear. That's kind of funny, it's a novelty, whatever, it's weird. But then while looking through our inventory at the office for other items in this video, I found this. Yeah. It's real. We somehow have this ear-shaped iPhone case, so I can actually give you my hands-on impressions. It kind of feels like an ear. It does have a little iPhone cutout. You can quite frankly just slide an iPhone in there. The best I could find was like an iPhone 4 that fits inside. I'm not sure because the camera cutout really doesn't align, but this does work, so I could be on a phone call and looks like I have a giant ear. Very weird iPhone accessory. Would not waste your money. I don't know how we got one, but these things actually they do exist, and they do actually work, sort of. All right, back to the stuff you'd actually want to buy. Fast chargers have been very popular these days. Apple sells their $20 fast charger. The more people that kind of experience the fast charging goodness on the iPhone really want to share that with other people. And as you kind of prepare for some stocking stuffers, let me introduce you to this charging brick from Aukey. It is 40 bucks. It's half the price of the ginormous Apple MacBook Pro charger, but it's also faster. 100 watts on the Aukey compared to 96 watts on the one from Apple's MacBook Pro charger. It's small, it's compact, it's very affordable at $40, and will charge just about anything. iPhone, iPad, wireless headphones, even the full-on MacBook Pro, this thing is able to deliver an incredible amount of power in a very compact size. So, little stocking stuffer, super cool, and it's nice to have this thing in your bag, and it will charge pretty much anything you can throw at it, up to 100 watts. Speaking of gifts for someone else or yourself, if you're looking to treat yourself, I've been a big fan of the HomePod Mini since it debuted. There was some kind of back and forth criticism when it was announced on how good it was going to be and what Apple could deliver for 100 bucks, but I do think for the price, you really do get a lot of value for this device. It's not going to sound as good as the full-priced and full-sized larger HomePod, but it does sound really good for the size and still has that same HomePod DNA. It's going to kind of use Apple's special systems to kind of give you the best audio experience and deliver that music or podcast in the best possible way for the room that the HomePod is in. Sounds really good, gets very loud, has some more smart home functionality as well. It's gonna be able to control more things. Siri continues to get better. And for $100, if you're looking for a really nice, really great sounding smart home speaker, you cannot go wrong with the HomePod Mini. Comes in this lighter finish or a darker kind of space gray finish. $100, so that's affordable in the Apple scale, and is a really great gift you should consider picking up if you're looking to get a new smart home speaker, or you're looking to get a new speaker to listen to some music. HomePod Mini, can't go wrong. And another really cool iPhone 12 accessory, because I just can't stay away from the Apple Store, is the MagSafe wallet adapter. This has also gotten some criticism when it launched. Early reviews, some of them were not too kind, but my experience with this has actually been pretty great. It seems to stick onto the back of the iPhone really well. It's a nice minimal wallet, holds about 3 or 4 cards, depending on kind of what cards you're gonna put in there. And it's a nice way if you're looking to kind of declutter from carrying a large bulky wallet, you're looking for something a little slimmer, a little more manageable, and even just on the weekends, if you just wanna put your ID and a couple of cards in here, stick it on the back of your iPhone and go, then you have that option with the MagSafe wallet. Comes in black, brown, and a number of other different finishes in colors. It is a leather material, which is super nice and premium, and pretty much works as advertised. So it's gotten some, you know, mixed reviews, but give it a fair shake. MagSafe wallet is definitely worth your time and attention if you're looking to kind of slim down, consolidate, and just have a nice simple wallet on the back of your new iPhone 12. Okay, for this next product, I gotta say, I had this in kind of the weird category. It looked odd and I wasn't really considering it as cool. But then the more I researched it, the more I found this is actually kind of ingenious. It's the Moonlight Storybook Projector. And essentially it clips onto the back of your iPhone and uses the flash to kind of project different images from a storybook onto the wall or the ceiling or whatever kind of surface you're looking to project onto. It's kind of like a 21st century ViewMaster, if you remember those things you kind of put and click through and look at the different pictures. This is a modern day approach to that with the iPhone. And it's weird but it's also kind of cool. It'll show the images on the screen, then it'll kind of show kind of a text overlay of the story that you can read while you're kind of projecting the story onto the ceiling. You can buy different stories. It's weird, but it's a really great use of the iPhone flash. And I don't know if this is weird or cool, but I had to mention it. It's one of those successful Kickstarter campaign stories. And I thought it was weird, but now I actually might kind of think differently. But next up for weird stuff, this is an iPhone case with a hand built onto the back of it. Yeah, this is just weird. Essentially, I guess the idea is that you can use your iPhone, but then also feel like you're holding someone's hand at the same time. I kind of get the idea, but I kind of don't. This just looks super weird. It looks weird, it functions weird. I don't really have anything good to say about this thing, but it does exist, and if you, I guess, were looking to feel the nice embrace of a plastic hand while you hold and use your iPhone, a product that will accomplish that does actually exist. And then last but not least, this is one that you can buy on Amazon today. I saw it advertised a bunch while researching for this video. It looks like that you can just pop your phone in there and you're gonna get basically a little OLED TV that pops out that gives you a crystal clear image of whatever on your iPhone. You can play games, you can watch movies, it's gonna magnify and it's going to look great. The only problem is that it does not actually work like that. It's a magnifying piece of glass. So you're going to have the distortion that comes along with that. It's not going to be crystal clear. It does not look as good as the pictures allude to. Take a look at some of these reviews and they kind of speak for themselves. They are not nearly anything close to what the pictures might allude to. So don't be fooled by one of these things. Very weird iPhone accessory that looks cool, but you should not waste your money on. It just does not deliver on its promises. All right, and I think that is it for weird iPhone accessories. Hopefully that was a good mix of really useful, cool iPhone accessories that I've enjoyed and I definitely would recommend to you guys. And also those weird ones that, I mean, the Kissinger thing, come on, and the umbilical cord, just some really weird ones that I'm going to never look at again after editing this video. Anyways, what do you guys think? What is your favorite iPhone accessory you've picked up for the iPhone 12 or an iPhone that you've had before that? Or maybe what's your worst iPhone accessory? What's the weirdest, creepiest thing that you've seen or that you've actually spent money on that just was weird and does not deliver on any of its promises? Let us know in the comments down below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm Robert Rosenfeld from the Apple Circle, and I will see you in the next one.